of Spirit. It is celebrated every 31st of August by the Ramon Magsaysay Award Foundation as a fitting homage to the legacy of the Philippine president who was once called Man of the Masses. He believed that the little man is entitled to a little bit more of everything, and that no one's dignity should ever be compromised. Today, over 300 ordinary men and women have displayed the same conviction and courage to transform society, and thus have been honored with the Ramon Magsaysay Award. For protecting fundamental human rights, for encouraging the poor to become asset creators, or for just playing music that colors the mind. And while the award can boost ordinary men and women to celebrity, many of the winners use it to enable them to work much harder for the communities they serve, because they know that the award is not about them, but about the solutions they make. That's how ordinary men and women become extraordinary.
Ramon Delfero Magsaysay, the 7th President of the Philippines, was one of the most revered global figures of his time. A true servant leader with a vision of hope, President Magsaysay commanded the admiration, respect, and affection of people because he was a man who embodied greatness of spirit. He saw his fellow human beings born with the right to live in liberty and happiness. He was angered at injustice and the violation of high principles. He worked to build a nation, a world in which all people were free and lived in honor and peace with one another. There are many stories that showcase Ramon Magsaysay's integrity, his honesty, the courage of his convictions, and his immeasurable concern for the common man. One of my favorites is about an artesian well. Exactly 68 years ago, President Magsaysay spent his birthday traveling the central part of Luzon Island and conversing with people despite the heavy downpour. In Pampanga Province, President Magsaysay saw an artesian well being installed with a homemade machine. The president was so impressed by the contraption that he looked for its investor and praised him. "You are a lot better than our Metropolitan Water District engineers," he said. President Magsaysay recommended that the water district hire the man who was rightfully given a job. President Magsaysay, through his leadership and greatness of spirit, has given countless opportunities for the Filipino people. Moreover, he gave each one of us countless reasons to be proud that we are Asians. Today, August 31, is the 115th birth anniversary of Ramon Magsaysay. The world is richer and better because Ramon Magsaysay lived in this world. The fragility of our present times cannot be overstated. We need more Ramon Magsaysays.
Good morning from Manila, the Philippines. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of the Ramon Magsaysay Award Foundation, we would like to thank you all for joining us in this momentous global event. Today is all about greatness of spirit. It is what we honor and celebrate through the Ramon Magsaysay Award, Asia's premier prize and highest honor. We at the Foundation are often asked, what is greatness of spirit? And to be frank, it is very hard to define. But we know it and feel it when we see it. Since 1958, we have sought greatness of spirit across Asia, and we found it in the Dalai Lama, then a young 24-year-old Tibetan leader fighting for his people's culture and identity. His Holiness received the Ramon Magsaysay Award in 1959. We found greatness of spirit in the life and work of Mother Teresa when she was quietly but tirelessly working for the poor and dying of Kolkata, India. She received the Ramon Magsaysay Award in 1962. We also found greatness of spirit in Chen Shuju, a very simple Taiwanese market vendor who continues to donate all her earnings to various charitable institutions in Taiwan. And as of 2021, she has donated over $1 million. She received the Ramon Magsaysay Award in 2012. Last year, we also found greatness of spirit in Roberto Cadodoy Balion, a Filipino fisherman who rallied his poverty-stricken community in restoring their marine resources, leading them to economic independence. He received the Ramon Magsaysay Award. The greatness of spirit that President Magsaysay has espoused during his lifetime lives on. We found them in 340 Ramon Magsaysay laureates over the past 63 years. While we cannot define greatness of spirit in mere words, James Rush, American historian and the Foundation's resident biography writer for 30 years, articulated what raises the Ramon Magsaysay awardees above the rest. It is the laureates' heightened sense of the common good and their capacity for sustained moral commitment as they pursue their individual life passions. This year, during the 64th year of the Ramon Magsaysay Award, four individuals will join our illustrious community of leaders. Four individuals who, through their transformative work, prove that greatness of spirit is alive and borderless. Ladies and gentlemen, Ramon Magsaysay Award Chairperson Aurelio R. Montinola III and members of our Board of Trustees will now announce the 2022 Ramon Magsaysay Awardees.
Good day from Manila, Philippines. Thank you for joining us from across Asia and the world. The Ramon Magsaysay Award has always been a celebration of the best of Asia and the best of humanity. And today, we begin the 64th Ramon Magsaysay Awards festival season by celebrating the greatness of spirit of this year's laureates. Members of the Board of Trustees of the Foundation will help me in announcing the 2022 Ramon Magsaysay Awardees.
Mental health is the scourge of our time. A dark cloud. It is a complex issue that is too compelling to be ignored. The Ramon Magsaysay Award Foundation believes there is a need to destigmatize and to demystify mental illness and the social context in which mental health thrives. In recent decades, we continue to contribute profoundly in the advocacy and discourse on mental wellness. And we have honored and recognized individuals who have driven forward more impactful solutions that harmonize the various efforts already underway to address the mental health crisis. Phon Sang Sinkeyo from Thailand in 1965. Jetsi Shanmugam from Sri Lanka in 2017. Kim Jong Ki from South Korea in 2019. And last year, for his work in Southeast Asia, Stephen Munsey. They will be the first to describe themselves as ordinary. But for the purposeful and direct work that they do, so that the affected person is not isolated and driven deeper into illness, they not only saved the soul, but healed broken communities. They have proven that empathy has no borders. They are truly extraordinary.
Thank you, Ernie. It is with great pride that I announce the first recipient of the 2022 Ramon Magsaysay Award. From Cambodia, Sotira Chim, our mental health champion. He has been instrumental in localizing and nuancing the approach of addressing and healing those with mental health issues through BATSBAT, a Cambodian trauma syndrome akin to post-traumatic stress disorder. We are honoring him for his efforts in providing psychological and mental care to Cambodians at the grassroots level for more than 20 years through the transcultural psychosocial organization Cambodia.
British doctors Sir Henry Holland and his son, Ronald Holland, have restored the sight of more than 150,000 nomads and plainsmen in Pakistan. They received the Ramon Magsaysay Award in 1960. Wealthy Fisher was an American educator who has trained more than 7,000 teachers in India and other Asian countries. She received the Ramon Magsaysay Award in 1964. Dr. Tetsu Nakamura was a Japanese doctor who was made an honorary citizen of Afghanistan for his efforts in helping close to a million people through medical and agricultural missions. He received the Ramon Magsaysay Award in 2003. For 64 years, the Ramon Magsaysay Award has been given to outstanding leaders, regardless of their race or nationality, who have transformed Asia for the better. The Hollands, Mrs. Fisher, and Dr. Nakamura are just some of our Magsaysay laureates who did not allow borders to define themselves or their work, but have proven that goodness is truly borderless.
Thank you, Shell. Our next Magsaysay laureate is from Japan, Tadashi Hattori, our sight-saving humanitarian. He is an ophthalmologist who has restored the vision of thousands of visually impaired patients in remote and disadvantaged areas of Vietnam. We honor him for his resolute commitment in helping thousands of Vietnamese people through his philanthropic medical efforts and for demonstrating the life-changing impact of dedicating one's time, talent, and treasures in the service of others.
In this period of the pandemic, it is unfortunate that the most vulnerable sector, children, has been overlooked. Sadly, children have been rendered almost invisible, along with their right to safe spaces. But even before the spread of COVID-19, the alarming rise in the incidence of children and teens who fall prey to a vicious culture that leaves deep wounds and scarred futures had already been a great concern. Clearly, there is a need to create compassionate systems that can combat this tendency towards violence that has insidiously become embedded in homes, schools, communities, even societies. And we need champions who relentlessly push for the opportunity to help young girls and boys, enabling them to fight their own battles without fear, so they can build a better future for themselves. The Ramon Magsaysay Award Foundation has honored individuals who have shown the courage and tenacity to advocate for the rights of children and have used their crusading work to sound the clarion call for child protection. Prathip Unsong Tham Hatha of Thailand in 1978, Kim Im-sun of South Korea in 1989, Shanta Sinha of India in 2003, Chung To of China in 2007. The impact of these Magsaysay laureates' inspiring work can be felt across borders in Asia.
Our third recipient of Asia's Premier Prize and highest honor is from the Philippines, Bernadette Madrid. Our children's rights and child protection crusader. She has been at the forefront in providing medical, legal, and psychosocial care to children and women who are victims of abuse. We are honoring her for her admirable commitment in championing the rights of the most vulnerable and for her transformative work in integrating child protection into the health infrastructure in the Philippines.
In the year 2000, the foundation introduced a new category, the Ramon Magsaysay Award for Emergent Leadership, which is bestowed on individuals 40 years old and under, or organizations 10 years old and below. The Ramon Magsaysay Award for Emergent Leadership affirms the importance of the work that young leaders dedicate their energies to and recognizes their great potential to accomplish even more through continued resilience, courage, and selfless leadership. Since 2001, the Foundation has conferred the Ramon Magsaysay Award for Emergent Leadership on some of Asia's best and brightest young leaders, and they include people like Aung Chantol of Cambodia, Arvind Kejriwal of India, Ananda Galapati of Sri Lanka, and last year, the organization Watchdog from Indonesia. Our Emergent Leadership laureates continue to prove that leadership and greatness of spirit know no age and no borders.
Thank you, Randy. This year, we are proud to add yet another promising young leader in our roster of Ramon Magsaysay awardees. From Indonesia, Gary Benecek Gibb, our anti-plastic pollution warrior. We are honoring him with the Emergent Leadership Award for his resilient work in addressing plastic pollution in his adopted country, and for being an outstanding example of leadership transcending age and borders. We proudly present to you the 2022 Ramon Magsaysay Awardees. From Cambodia, Sotira Chim. From Japan, Tadashi Hattori. From the Philippines, Bernadette Madrid. From Indonesia, Gary Benecek Gibb.
The Foundation is inviting everyone to join us for all the public events of the 64th Ramon Magsaysay Awards Festival season. All our 2022 Ramon Magsaysay awardees will have their virtual public lectures from September to November 2022. And we invite the whole Asia and the world to celebrate with us on November 30, 2022, for the 64th Ramon Magsaysay Awards presentation ceremonies to be live streamed from Manila, Philippines. Please visit our website, www.rmaward.asia, and all our social media channels for more information. Thank you, everyone, for joining us today, and we wish you all a truly inspiring day ahead. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our 2022 Ramon Magsaysay awardees for this year. Congratulations to all of you. And I, you know, before we put them all up on the various squares, I just wanted to thank our researchers. It all started with you guys, our nominators. Of course, our esteemed Board of Trustees for once again choosing this illustrious group of just human beings. And I also wanted to thank all the past laureates that have joined us today, our friends and supporters of the foundation, and of course, the staff of the Ramon Magsaysay Award Foundation that put this all together. And I can see, look, in some of the squares, we have a lot of people cheering for the winners. There you go. Hello, everybody. There's Chiclet and there's Noemi and the entire group, celebrating with everyone all over Asia and all over the world. I'd like to just say hello first and foremost to some of the people that are having some watch parties. Dr. Chim in Phnom Penh, hello, how are you? How are you doing, Dr. Chim? I know that you called for an emergency meeting with your staff today. Do you want to turn on your microphones and just say hello quickly? We can give one big cheer for Dr. Chim. Dr. Chim, was your staff surprised? Because I know, thank you for promising not to say anything until today. Your microphone is off.
Sorry. Yeah. Yes, thank you.
Hello, everybody in Phnom Penh. Hello. Isn't Dr. Chim just awesome?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
All right. Now we also would like to just turn the camera. Gary, are you in Bali? Where are you, Gary? Because I know that you also have a live watch party going on. Gary, are you there?
Yeah. Thank you so much, Ms. Susan. I'm here in Bali with my folks, with my family here, my brother and sister, co-founders. But everybody is watching from my team at the set stations. So, very, very proud. What an honor this is all to us.
Well, congratulations and to your family as well, because we all know that, behind every young, successful man is a wonderful family behind him. The support system that he's had over the years has been incredible. And we want to also congratulate all of you because you're all part of this. So see you in Manila soon. See you in Manila soon. We also want to highlight Dr. Bernie Madrid because we know that Dr. Bernie has also invited many of her teammates all over the Philippines, all her child protection units. Dr. Madrid?
Yes. Thank you. They're all over the place. It was very difficult to keep it a secret because if you send a notice, people will immediately say, why? And they start suspecting. But I'm glad that at least until today, it was only kept to a very small group because we are preparing. Yeah.
Wonderful. And of course, Dr. Tadashi Hattori. Dr. Hattori, thank you for joining us, even if you're in Maui. Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations. You truly are the epitome of individual social responsibility. When people say, I cannot do it, you will be the role model moving forward to say, yes, it can be done. So congratulations, Dr. Hattori. Okay. You have your microphone off, so I didn't know if you wanted to say something. No? Okay. All right. Okay. We promised that this was not going, that we were not going to go beyond 20-25 minutes. I didn't know if our chairperson, Mr. Gigi Montinola, or any of our esteemed board of trustees would like to say something. I can see Ramon, I can see Randy, and some of the laureates too. Yuk Chang is with us and a couple of others. So we'll just open the microphone. Go ahead.
Well, if I may, let me just say congratulations to all the new laureates. You add more prestige to the Ramon Magsaysay Awards by being recipients and by accepting the awards, because it is your work that makes the prize even more meaningful as we move forward. So heartiest congratulations to you and all the best. And congratulations for all the great work you're doing. Thank you.
As Susan has previously explained, greatness of spirit is hard to define. But by just looking at the four of you and what you've done, the definition jumps out of the page. So congratulations again to all of you.
Yes, let me add my voice to congratulations. Truly, you are a blessing to humanity, and of course, a particular blessing to Asia. So we are so happy to add you to the roster of distinguished Ramon Magsaysay laureates. And I have to warn you, there's a lot of work ahead coming. So, but that simply means spreading your greatness of spirit to others. So again, congratulations, and look forward to seeing you soon.
Susan, may I also add my words of congratulations to our outstanding and deserving Ramon Magsaysay laureates. You are the epitome of greatness of spirit. Congratulations, and keep up the good job you're doing. Thank you.
My congratulations too, if I may, to our four awardees this year. I think you may have to conserve your energy, because you will certainly be hounded by people who will be seeking interviews with you.
Okay.
From today. Congratulations to all four of you.
Thank you.
Okay. And with that, thank you. Maraming salamat from Manila, Philippines. And we look forward to seeing you all November 30, 2022 at Ramon Magsaysay Center in person to receive your awards and to make you experience a little bit of Filipino hospitality. Thank you. Have a great day and continue the celebration with your family. And you know, the people that you work with, because they all deserve the award with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, everybody. Thank you.
See you soon. November.
Congratulations again to everyone.
Thank you.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you so much.
For you.